Hey everyone, my name is Adrian here with Maze Homestead Chronicles. We're going to show you the easiest way to make biochar. So first things first, dig you a pit, and it doesn't have to be this big. This pit's about 2 feet deep, probably about 3 feet wide, and the length on it is around 6 feet. You can pretty much, I'm about 6'1", and I could lay down here. But I like it big like this because if I have bigger branches and different garden waste, I have plenty of space to throw those in here without chopping them up. But you don't have to have one this big, okay? This is just what we have. All right, so now that you've got your pit ready, we're gonna need a few things, okay? So let's go ahead and I'll show you what those are. So the lobbers are gonna be used for just cutting your garden waste to a more manageable size. So, you know, don't get too worried about the size and all that stuff if you got a decent sized pit, but I like to, you know, just clean them up a little bit, make them a little bit more workable.
Just keep dropping them in and burying the material. Having something to poke the fire with is important too, and I forgot to mention that at the beginning of the video, so make sure you have something to just kind of put the limbs back in there so you don't burn yourself.
All right, now we're gonna start dropping these different materials down in here. A lot of this wood that I have is just like rotten wood, and so it's not really that great for our stove that we have. So we're just gonna make biochar out of it.
This bark is fantastic also.
So we're just letting this get hot. Just keep throwing on a little bit every so often, but see how we're burying all the materials down below. But down in here, you can see it's real hot. It's making its way up. All right, so now you just wait until this burns down quite a bit, it becomes ember. So go inside, have yourself a coffee, whatever you gotta do, and you can come back, check on it again. Or you can sit by it, enjoy the nice warmth on a winter day.
So as this is burning, keep in mind that don't be scared of ash. Like, so many people freak out about ash, you know, like other things, where it's like, oh, we can't have any amount of ash in it, and I will show you how we get the ash and everything off of it later. So it's not a big deal, it's part of the process, and there's lots of tribes and different people around the world that do it this way and have been doing it this way for centuries and don't have any kind of fancy systems like some people have. So we'll show you how that all works here in a little bit. Hey Rusty, what do you think about all this, huh? What do you think?
All right, so now the wood has all burned down. It's mainly embers now. So we're gonna start moving these bigger pieces of wood that aren't finished. It's okay to have stuff that's not finished. What we do is just bring it to the side, just like this.
All right, now my son's gonna go ahead and douse this with water. the next step. So here's what it looks like once it's all cooked and hosed down. That's the good stuff right there. All right, so now that we've got all the embers doused and cooled off, we can go ahead and start scooping it out and putting it into a wheelbarrow. This stuff still has smoke, but it's not hot to the touch. So look, as you can see, we've got different size plant materials here that have turned into charcoal that we're gonna make into biochar. And each of these little plant fibers that we use has different minerals and nutrients to offer to the garden soil. These are the things you're gonna need. You're gonna need a canvas cloth. You can get this at hardware stores. And you're gonna need you a tamper and of course your charcoal, okay? All right, so whenever you put this cloth down, you want a good solid hard ground, okay? So right here we just have clay and that's perfectly fine. You can use concrete, you could use gravel. We've done it on top of gravel before, but for this video, we're gonna do it on clay. So you just get your cloth, set it out. Now just spread it out evenly across. And basically what this canvas cloth is doing is it's catching all the different bits that are gonna be broken up here in a sec. That way we can take it and dump it back into our wheelbarrow and put it where we want it. All right, now we're gonna go ahead and start using the tamper to break up these and make it into smaller bits. When you make it smaller, that's more surface area for microorganisms to get in. All right, so my son's gonna move this a little bit, kind of stir it up so we can get those bigger chunks that we may have missed. So when you crush it up like this, not only is it more surface area for the microorganisms and all that, but it's also gonna make your material go a lot further. If you have a bunch of just really big chunks like this, they don't go as far. So when you break it up real small, it goes a lot further in the garden bed. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna take this, me and my son, and we're gonna show you how to put it in here the easiest way. Okay, Russ. So we'll bring in this side first. Just kind of get it all. All right, look, the first and most popular way to inoculate your biochar is to take it just as is after you've done all that we've done up to this point, and just take it and toss it into your compost piles, okay? So you can throw it into your compost piles and then later on stir it up and flip it over when you throw more on, like over here. We got a fresh compost pile. And we can just toss it on top. And then like, we've got some scraps. And when you throw all that in there,
It's just gonna soak up all the nutrients. Let this sit and compost through fully, and it'll be ready to go in the garden. All right, for this next method of inoculation, what we have here, now listen, there's so many different ways to do this. If you don't have these materials, it's okay. You can use rainwater and urine. Those two are fantastic, and you don't need all this. But since I've already got these resources, I'm using them. What I have here is I've got, this is urine, rainwater, and there's comfrey. There's some comfrey leaves that are already broken down. So I'm gonna use this. I've got a finished compost here. I've got leaf mold, and then I've got chicken manure and urine. What we're gonna do, there's no specific, you know, like amount of each one. This is just how I've been doing it. So biochar in here. Gonna go ahead and get out of here. So I'm filling this 5 gallon bucket up about halfway roughly. All right, so now we've got it full of our biochar that has not been inoculated. And now what we're gonna do is I'm gonna take the manure first. Go ahead and dump that in. Okay, and then compost, leaf mold. Still got a little bit more manure there. And then we're gonna take this, which is our comfrey tea, rainwater, and urine. Pour that in there. And then we'll take some extra urine, I guess. Dump some more of that in there. And remember, it doesn't have to be like this exact amount. We want the biochar that has not been inoculated. We want that to be filled up and all the pores and everything to absorb the nutrients that we're putting in here. The chicken manure, rainwater, urine, comfrey tea, compost, leaf mold, all the different fungi and different things. All right, and go ahead and give it a stir at the very end once you put all your ingredients. Give it a good little stir. Agitate it a little bit there. All right, so this is the last one that I wanted to share because it's the most simple. You may not have all these the resources that I have. So if you just have rainwater and urine, that's perfect. So we're gonna go ahead and take our biochar that has not been inoculated yet, put that in our bucket. Now we're gonna fill it up with rainwater. Now I've got about a quarter of a gallon of urine here. That's all we need. You can dump that in as you're doing the rainwater. Fill this all the way up. When I say all the way up, it just needs to be covering all the biochar here, okay? So there you have it. It's good to go. This will be ready in at least 3 days minimum, but the longer it sits, the better. Remember, more nutrients, and that just means more nitrogen that's gonna leach out into your garden soil. All right, so this is a batch of biochar, inoculated biochar that we've had sitting here for over a week. You've only gotta let it sit in your liquid fertilizer for 3 days. Okay, that's minimum. The longer, the better, of course. But I'll let you kind of see what this looks like. So, very rich stuff. It's already ready to go for the garden. I don't have to put this in my compost pile. It's ready to go straight into the soil. That's it. If you enjoyed the video, please give it a thumbs up. And if you haven't already subscribed, consider subscribing to see the rest of our content. We'll see you at the next video. God bless y'all. Bye-bye.